यूरोपीय यूनियन इन 1945 टू 1957 प्रीलिमिनरी आफ्टर वर्ल्ड वॉर टू यूरोपियन यूनियन इंटीग्रेशन वाज सीन एज एन एंटीडोट टू द एक्सट्रीम नेशनलिज्म विच हैड डिवास्टेटेड पार्ट्स ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट इन अ स्पीच डिलीवर्ड ऑन 19 सितंबर 1946 एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द ज्यूरिख स्विट्जरलैंड विंस्टन चर्चिल वेंट फर्दर एंड एडवोकेटेड द इमर्जेंस ऑफ द यूनाइटेड स्टेट ऑफ यूरोप एंड द 1948 हेग्यू कांग्रेस वाज अ पिवोटल मूवमेंट इन द यूरोपियन पैटर्न हिस्ट्री एज इट लेड टू द क्रिएशन ऑफ द यूरोपियन मूवमेंट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल एंड द कॉलेज ऑफ यूरोप वर यूरोप फ्यूचर लीडर वुड लिव एंड स्टे टुगेदर इट आल्सो लेड डायरेक्टली टू द फाउंडिंग ऑफ द काउंसिल ऑफ यूरोप इन 1949 द फर्स्ट ग्रेट एफर्ट टू ब्रिंग द नेशंस ऑफ यूरोप together initially 10 of them. The council focused primarily on values, human rights and democracy rather than on economic or trade issues and also was always as a forum where sovereign governments could choose to work together with no supranational authority. It raised great hopes of further European integration and there were favored debates in 2 years that followed as to how this could be achieved. But in 1952, disappointed at what they saw as the lack of progress within the Council of Europe, six nations decided to go further and created the European Gold and Steel Community, which was declared to be a first step in the Federation of Europe. This community helped to economically integrate and coordinate the large number of the Marshall Plan funds from the United States. European leader Alcide D. Gasperi from Italy, Jean Monnet and Robert Schuman from the France and the Paul Henri Spaak from Belgium understood that the coal and the steel were the two industries essentially for waging war and they believed that by tying their national industries together, future war between their nations become much less likely. These men and others are officially credited as the founding father of the European Union. Treaty of Rome, 1957 to 1992. In 1957, Belgium, France, Italy, Luxembourg, and Netherlands and West Germany signed the Treaty of Rome, which created the European Economic Community and established a custom union. They also signed another pact creating the European Atomic Energy Community for a cooperation in the deploying nuclear energy. Both treaties came into force in 1958. The EEC and the Euratom were created separately from the ECSC and they shared the same courts and the common assembly. The EEC was headed by Walter Hallstein and Euratom was headed by the Louis Armand and then Antony Herissig. Euratom was to integrate sector in nuclear energy while the EEC would develop a customs union among the members. During the 1960s, tensions began to show with France seeking to limit supranational power. Nevertheless, in 1965, an agreement was reached on 1st July 1967, the merger treaty created a single set of the institutions for the three communities which were collectively referred to as the European Communities. Jean Rey presided over the first merged commissions. In 1973, the commissions were enlarged to include Denmark, Ireland and the United Kingdom, Norway, and they negotiated to join at the same time, but the Norwegian voters rejected membership in a referendum. In 1979, the first direct elections to the European Parliament were held. Greece joined in 1981. Portugal and Spain followed in 1986. In 1985, these Schengen agreements paved the way for the creation of an open border without passport control between the most member states and some non-member states. In 1986, the European flag began to be used by the EEC and the Single European Act was signed. In 1990, after the fall of the Eastern Bloc, the former East Germany became part of the communities as part of the reunified Germany. A close fiscal integration with the introduction of the euro was not matched by the institutional oversight, making things more troubling. Attempts to solve the problem and to make the European Union more efficient and coherent had limited success.